what is the role of a techno manager in the post-COVID world, but before the post-COVID also. Only the COVID situation has accentuated. It has given a re-emphasis. It has told us, which we knew already, but we were not willing to accept, that you cannot work in this world without having a proper technology backbone and the managers knowing about the technology. Okay. Now, while the healthcare workers and the police and everybody was, they called the corona warriors, there was a silent warrior. And what is a silent warrior? IT. The people who manage the IT, who people who enabled the classrooms, who enabled our e-commerce sites, who enabled our telecom network. I mean, they are the people. They led the work. They continued with the growing of the work, okay? Even the collaboration taking place. So as a manager, we need to pay respect that unless we have a proper knowledge, you know, you don't have to be tech guru or nerd or programmer or software developer. There are people around it. There are engineers for doing this. You don't have to do that. But you as a manager must know how this can be utilized for your benefit. And for that, I am giving example of my home, you know, and then you might be able to relate with it. Suppose you want to buy, I go and buy a new oven, okay, and cooking range. Who is the right person to decide? The guy who makes the cooking range or the person who uses it? Obviously, it will be the person, my spouse or my family member, they will be telling me that this cooking range is no good because it does not serve my purpose. So what is the role of a manager? Manager has to decide what technology can be utilized by me. Okay, that is fun. But before that, they have to know what is cooking range. If you don't know what is cooking range, if a villager who is not exposed to any modern gadget and you tell them to decide that this is a cooking range or a microwave oven or whatever, then he or she will not be able to decide. So the first role of a manager is to help deciding technology acquisition. Now that you have acquired the technology, your second role would be to start enabling its use. So you are a manager, you will have your workers, you will have a support staff, you will have to encourage them. I can take example of my own team here in BIMTEC. The moment my managers started to use, my faculty started to use online class, it started to percolate all over the place. Okay. Every staff member started to use it. And now we became in 3 months' time very, very comfortable. As a matter of fact, today nobody talks about it because everybody is comfortable. I mean, everybody has got more expertise than I have, because that's how we started up. So in order to cap this thought number one, technology has got two factors. One factor is it will help us do our job better. Okay. Efficiently, effectively, cost-effective manner. That is job number one. The second job is that it can help us change. Technology is also a vehicle of change. Okay. Now, very, very simply, you know, the online classes have started, the webinars have started. BIMTEC has changed its track. You know, it has started to offer now online courses. Okay. Online courses, short-term courses, etc., etc. So, this is our technology is the second potential. So what I will do is that I will ask you to watch these two short videos and tell me what is the technology involved and why I am showing this these two videos to you. So this is the video number one, and are you able to see my screen, Prince? The video?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. So now, this first video doesn't have any sound, but it will play for a minute or so. Just watch it and say why I am showing this video to you. Because this is a class about techno-savvy manager in the post-COVID world. So there is a bamboo. which is used by a team of commandos, and they climb up. There is a need to climb up silently because some terrorists have taken hostage some school children, and you can't go with the through the staircase, or you can't drop them from the helicopter because the noise comes up and they will start harming them. So video number one, okay, let's see the other video. So just write why this video is, I'm showing it to you. Let me show you the another video. Keep writing, you know, what you think, why these videos are being shown, because they have got some message for us. I am skipping it a little bit. To avoid this video, so let me just go over and see your chats. What is your response? Any comment here? Anyone? Okay, I will wait for your comments to come. I'm going ahead with my inputs to you. So basically, the technology has got two roles to perform. Are you able to see my screen?
Very interesting slide, which talks about that there is a bi-directional relationship between technology and the business. Most of the time, the business needs drive the technology to help them with efficiency and so on. However, in the case of emerging technology, it is also a vehicle for innovation, which shapes and enhances the business needs and new
opportunity. So what you have is that you have got a company called Amazon, which is started off a e-commerce company 25 years ago, and like many companies started as a e-commerce company selling CDs and books. Today what Amazon is not only the world's largest e-commerce company, most very valuable company, giving fight to Walmart and others, and then they are also the video streaming company. Okay, Amazon is also getting into insurance, and so Amazon is also the largest cloud service provider, AWS. And how they have done is that they have got the next metaphor of caterpillar to butterfly. Paytm for our country, it is started as a Paytm payment wallet. As a matter of fact, it is started as a subcontracted to Airtel 10 years ago, and they launched their first offering on Airtel mobile phone, saying buddy recharge. So if I have got a talk time in my mobile phone, in my then I can transfer it to my friend because he wants to talk to it, use it. This buddy recharge is nothing but our Paytm wallet, and today Paytm can be used for paying bills, for doing anything, for buying movie tickets, for buying gold, and doing lot of many things. So there are two perspective. The first perspective is a commando climbing the wall, where the bamboo is a technology which helps people to do the impossible. Okay, without bamboo they can't climb. So similarly way, if I have got a technology, there are about 40 odd students here, or people listening to me, I can conduct this class from my classroom or my home or wherever, and we are able to continue with our education without much hassle. Of course, I can't touch you, I can't feel you. As a matter of fact, we should not touch you each other because of the corona thing. So this is very important. As a manager, while we have to take the first three roles, finding the technology which is useful to me, secondly, the use of this technology with our people, and third is, once you start using it, find what further it can do, you know, innovating with the technology. And that is where this this two arrow comes up. First, you start using it, how the technology can help. And secondly, you say how it can make my a caterpillar to butterfly. And there are several examples which the companies have used the technology. Now, who brings this caterpillar to butterfly? You. You as a manager, because you know the need of the customer, you know how the technology can help the customer, how a chatbot can help in serving the customer better. In if you come to BIMTech, we have got a program here in a technology where we talk about emerging technology. We enable people to do exercises on making chatbots and then the blockchain and IoT lab. So what you get is that you become more aware and appreciative of how technology can change your world. So when you go to the place of work, you will be viewed as more respect, because you know that you know how the technology can change your world. Now, so this is a Gartner report which says that post-COVID, some of the trends are taking place. There are 9 future trends. I have just picked up the 7 of them which are more relevant in the context of what we are talking about. Basically, more and more people will work remotely. And there will be travel restrictions, there will be a scar of pandemic, etc. The data will be more. You know, even today, I can collect this data. What is the data? Our recording. This is the data. Okay. Your question and answer is the data. Your chat is the data. So the moment I will have more and more such data, we will be able to generate more information and more insight onto it. Secondly, contingent worker expansion, which means that you may not have all the people, and that is something with related with your job, that you may not have all the people with you for full time, but someday you might need some more people. So what you do is that you go to temporary workers. You know, contingent workers are temporary workers. They can work. You know, just now we were having some discussion in the other room. We are trying to build a recording studio in our BIMTech, and then some discussion is going on. And then the question came in that, do we hire a video editor or we do something else? So the guy who came, he said, no, don't hire it. There is a site here where there are people from Bangladesh or something. They give you very cheap labor. Okay. Now, contingent workers. Okay. Why do I hire a person whom I am only using for half an hour or 2 hours in a week? Expand your employer as a safety net. Now, this is something about society, not related with the technology, but the employers have to play a major role, where if there is a restriction of travel or something, they should be more open to allow you to work from home and then give some kind of safety net so that you do not lose off your job, right? Then your critical skill and the roles. So that will be separated, where you might be performing many roles than what your skills are. You know, sometimes you may have to do a little bit more, like it happened in the lockdown. Many of us have to do our homework or work in the chores of the home because there was no help coming in. Then complexity will increase, and then you have to increase your reinvention through more and more, increase your resilience through more and more reinvention. So why you should be a tech savvy manager? Because of the complexity increasing. I mean, just take a simple example of our day-to-day life. You are taking a decision to drive back home. How do you take your decision that which route to take? You go to the Google Map, okay? And that tells you the shortest path. Complexity has increased. Google Maps is guiding you. Now, if you have to take decision about how much inventory I have to keep, you just don't go by line of sight. You try to understand that what type of consumption is taking place, what is the future projection, and so on and so forth. You will have endless data. Endless data means endless innovation. You can take some very simple example of Netflix or YouTube, where you start watching certain type of movies or serials, they will start recommending you. You go to the Amazon, they say, because you bought this, because somebody bought this, they also bought that. That is a innovation they are trying to do. Okay. Google is one innovation. Now, it is not that only big guys will do the innovation. Each company has to do the innovation. Then only they will be able to survive it. and the structure is also changing, and your credibility depends. If you are a tech manager, if you are not a tech manager, then people will say, oh, this guy doesn't know. Okay. So if he doesn't know, perhaps he or she may not be the right person for me to hire. So you becoming a tech savvy manager is very, very essential, because you will be working from your home, and you need to know how to work it through using the collaboration tool. Okay. So what you do, you need to have a proficiency with the digital technology that will give power to you. So what are the skills required in post-pandemic work? Basically, you should have good communication and emotional intelligence, because it might be a little taxing on you. You are working remotely, and then there could be some issues. Second is that you have to be flexible and adaptable. Okay? You might be working from home, but there may be a meeting in the evening. So you can't say that 5 o'clock is done, we can't come, because you are being given free time in the day also. Then you have to be more creative and innovative, because you need to find some way how to collaborate. I mean, I take my students on Jamboard, you know, where we utilize Jamboard, where the group of students of our class work together to on an assignment. Okay. I mean, I can show you the Jamboard assignment in a minute, and then you will appreciate what this collaboration means, and all done within a period of 10 minutes. Okay. They're asked that, look, you do it now, read this case study, and then replace it. Now, same, thus something was not possible even in the physical classroom, because they were all sitting together. I would have given the case study, and they would have sat up with each other, and they have read it and writing it. Now it becomes very easy for them to do it in the Jamboard. So what you need to do, you have to be tech savvy, because 82% of the job requires digital skill. So if you do not have a digital skill, and if you're not interested in acquiring the digital skill, then you should work in, let's say, at your home. Okay, that's all. Even at your home, it will become very difficult. And finally, you need to have the critical thinking. The critical thinking is your ability, which is encompasses everything together. Of course, it doesn't have to go with the technology, but it helps you to select the right technology for you. So,
knows is to seek and grab new opportunities. The task is your unique value proposition, and body is you have to create an innovation ecosystem. You can't just do everything all by yourself. And then you need to be built on four strong pillars of strategy, competency, skill, and practice management. And finally, your tail must guide others, collaborate, and create an intellectual capital. This is the 9 emerging technology block. We are not covering the green ones, because we believe that this is something which you know already. However, if there is an interest in the class, I can take some short discussion, and then I can work on video. But you need to do your job as a consultant, ATVI consultant, would be that how can the current challenges be met? How can we find the
problem? So you can continue with your session.
So I thought I'll stop here and then give some time, more time for you to ask questions, because that may be a better thing to do. Most companies, one of our chief guests in one of our recent functions, he said that those companies who had far more digital managers could survive in this period much better than those people who were already working without any digital support and knowledge. You know, very difficult to train people. Let me tell you, it is easy to train face to face, but training people on a digital technology remotely was much, much difficult. Okay. So all of us, all of you have to have this desire. And I want to know, if you do not have any desire, then how to get this desire one can inculcate with you. So let's see some of the comments here. I know this is my pet two short videos. Caterpillar video shows that all we have to, Anmay Pandey, we all have to hone our skills regularly, and Commando video, in my opinion, so is work as a team, right? So definitely you have to work as a team. in the commando video also is a shows that there is a use of a technology to achieve the impossible. In this task, it is just a bamboo, but in some other task, like we are using an impossible task of cutting to how many, 28 people on the Zoom, very easily, as if we are talking to each other face to face. There is a recording which could be done. We can work through it. So good, Anmay, thank you. Then Sangeeta says that we need to have technology in order to complete the task. Definitely, if you do not have technology, how will you complete a task? Unless you are running a small kiosk or something, even then you will need a Paytm wallet for you to receive money from people. Even the cart vendors switch to digital payment. So you have to have some technology in some form. Then there is a question about the e-certificate. So I think BIMTEC has already answered that. Any other question? Because it is very important for me or for all of us, because BIMTEC is offering not only specialization in IT domain, but all other courses are digital enabled. So even if you are taking marketing, you will have courses like digital marketing or HR analytics and so on. Anshumanji?
So there is one more question which says, difference can a biotechnology undergraduate make in management?
Come back and say that again.
Yeah, I'll repeat it, sir. What difference can a biotechnology undergraduate make in management?
Okay, very good. So I'm just dissecting your word, biotechnology. So what is biotechnology? Something to do with biology. Okay, you are using technology to do something in the biology. Now, a management graduate is an application guy. Okay, he finds application for its customer. He has to do marketing, he has to do sales, he has to manage his people, he has to manage finance. Okay, now biotechnology is like physics, okay, now, or chemistry, and the pharmacy is what we are talking about as an application. So management to biotechnology would be like pharmacy to chemistry. So biotechnology, when you look at, you will see that there are companies who are engaged in the biotechnology. I mean, they will need management graduates for their functional areas. There are products companies who are making products for biotechnology, the research equipments, and they might be doing some other services related with this. So you as a management graduate, but if you want to sell a biotechnology product or biotechnology services, you need to know what the biotechnology is. Okay, suppose I go, I'm the front office guy in a hotel. I must know what services I provide, because my customer will be asking that question. Okay, I need not be a cook, I need not be a detailed technical guy, but I need to know what kind of recipe and how this recipe can be used. You go to the car salesperson, the person does not know how the car is made. But if you ask any question about the capability of the car, how the car works, what is its comparison, how it stands as compared to other cars, that person can tell you. So you are the front office guy. Management graduates are front office guy. You just have to understand how your back office works, and then you use it for your pleasing or the serving your customer.
Okay, there is one more question I have, sir, for you. Aman wants to know, I have 2 years work experience in digital marketing. Doing MBA in BIMTEC will help me.
Oh, immensely. You have just touched one part of the digital marketing. This is maybe how to market on social media or e-commerce and something like that. But technology management is a whole lot of things. Okay, if you want to become a senior manager, unless you want to spend your entire life in digital marketing. Remember, MBA or PGDM gives you a cutting edge. It haunts your capability. Okay. What it does is that you become more valuable to your company because you are able to find new business. You able to serve the customer. Okay, you are not just limited for doing some task which is told by someone else. You are able to innovate their process. You are able to find out. You will be able to answer what digital marketing we should do. Okay, and what how it is related for the benefit of my sale. Immense benefit. You know, if you have got 2 years work experience, that is the right time for you to take up this MBA program.
Sir, I have another question. Shibhi Krishna wants to ask, how fresher can survive in this field strongly? I think the attendee basically wants to know that as techno manager or in this emerging scenario where technology is very, very prominent, how probably a fresher can survive?
Oh, don't worry about this fresher. You know, as a matter of fact, you stand to gain faster in technology world. The reason is that you are uncontaminated. You only need 3 things. Okay, 3 D's. And what is the first thing? Desire. You have to have a desire to learn. The moment you learn to have a desire, nothing can stop you. So typically what happens is that if I know something already half, then I don't want to learn more. Okay. So as a fresher, you are like a clean slate. Okay. Clean slate. And you will learn very fast. Okay. So first you have to have a desire. This is something which nobody can give you. Nobody in the earth can give you. Even your parents cannot create desire in you. Okay. You have to create your own desire. The second is, once you have created the desire, now you have to decide what is my goal. Destination. Okay. And your destination is that I'm a fresher and I'm joining MBA. I need to join a telecom company or a retail company or something like that. That is your destination. Now, third is the D is drive for results. So you say, what type of skills are required to join the telecom company? What type of skills are required to join the FMCG? What type of skills are, that is where your MBA education comes up. And that equips you with all that, you know, the wherewithal, you know, like you have to climb a new mountain. The mountaineer has a backpack, you know, backpack has got a lot of equipment, you know, gears, which helps him to climb the mountain. So MBA creates that for you.
Okay, next question I have, sir, is from Himanshu. He wants to know which role is good in the long run for IT. Managerial or technical?
Okay, so I sometimes give, let me see if I can draw that. Where is my? Can I draw here? I don't see my.
Please share your screen.
Right, let me share the screen. I don't see the board. Okay, forget it. So I'm not seeing the whiteboard. Okay, whiteboard. So your question was that what is the role for IT, technical role as a managerial role? So remember the capital letter I. Just put that letter I in front of you. So if you're an IT guy, there is a bottom line, you know, which is the bottom line, the line at the bottom, which is a horizontal line. And there is one vertical line. And then you have got a top horizontal line. So when you start your career, divide this bottom to up about say 20 years. Initially, you should know, and mark my words, you should know something of everything. So if you're an IT guy, you should know something about networking, something about software development, something about AI, something about, you should know something about everything so that you know a holistic world, you know, like Delhi. If I'm in Delhi, I should know where is the North Delhi, South Delhi. I may not know every street, that doesn't matter. But I should know that if I have to travel from north to east, which road is better? Something about everything. Now, what is the central word? There you try to do the specialization. Okay, there you specialize a technology, a function, okay, and a business vertical. The business vertical could be FMCG, the function could be marketing, and what is the third ordinate of the cube? Technology. Okay. So function, business, and technology. In the technology, you can say ERP, you might say networking, you might say something else, you know, or maybe something more. So you should know everything of something. So you started with the bottom horizontal line, something of everything. Now second bottom line is everything of something. Okay. Now you go to the top, and that will take around 10 to 12 years. At that time, you realize that now I have seen a lot of things. Now I can expand my knowledge. For example, a child, when the child starts speaking in one language, you don't teach child five languages at the same time. Maybe one or two. Mostly the mother tongue you teach, okay? The child. Once he knows the language, now you can switch it to France or French or German or whichever, because now you know the construct of the language. So what you do on the top is many things of many things. So you try to expand your knowledge as you go along. So in your first career has to be a generalist career, for, and that is where your, as a matter of fact, MBA education gives you that. It gives you a little bit of marketing, sales, HR, operation, IT, everything it gives you. Okay. Now you choose your vertical, and I've told you the three verticals, so as choose a cube function. You can use this model here, Faraday's law. Okay. Remember in your physics. So you have got this function here. Okay. You have got a function, and you have got this technology. And then you have got industry, because you know that the function in a FMCG marketing function will be totally different than education. Okay, our admission team is basically our marketing team. You know, they are the one who deal with the new customers. Okay, but that function is totally different if you're selling something in a big bazaar. Okay, but that remains the same. In both cases, there are new people who are interested in the prospect or the company or the services, and they are coming to us. So three things. So IT person, I can tell you very safely for my own, I started as a coder. Okay. And after that, I did my MBA. Then I started to get into project management, business consulting, business analyst. And then I started to pick up more and more management role. Okay. So now I understand the technology. And remember, I'm not saying that you have to leave tech. Even today, I am hands-on. Okay, I have to be hands-on. To an extent, it is desired. Okay, so you have to keep both in your point.
Okay, Himanshu, I'll just add to what sir has said. Basically, you ought to become a T-shaped professional in today's world, where you have a wide range of knowledge and understanding, but have an in-depth knowledge and know-how of a certain chosen area of your specialization. Now moving on to the next question, Mr. Sai Deepak is raising his hand for the past several minutes. Sir, basically he wants to know that does pursuing MBA is good and to get job based on techno manager in IT role with hands-on package can be expected in this criteria?
Simplify the question. Question seems to be complicated. Tell me.
Basically, he wants to know the job prospects and definitely in terms of remuneration and ROI related to IT. His IT role as a job based in techno manager.
Okay, so ROI you calculate. Okay, don't just talk about the fee. There are a lot of ROI. You can take. Suppose I'm a running a business which generates me 50 crore of profit. Okay. And if I leave it for go to the MBA and then my business will collapse, then I have to take that as my base cost. But leave that aside. All I'm telling you that if you are taking this role and the IT manager, and you have got three or four choices. Okay. The first choice is IT companies. In the IT companies, they require MBAs for their front end functions, business consulting, marketing, business development, HR, those are the roles open to you. Now, even today, I was seeing the placement request from our placement colleagues, whole lot given. Now you can acquire some proficiency in certain technologies along the way. You know, for example, SAP or data analytics or whatever. So then they will put you in responsible in those projects where this technology is being used, because there could be many technologies. Okay. Now, I mean, even the package, I will leave my admission team to share with you, but you have got far more capability to get, make yourself valuable. I can tell you an example of a IB student and two students 2 years back. At that time, the AI had just come in. And what they did was that in our class, they learned how to make chatbots. And then next time when the placement interview came, both of them said, in emerging technology, what do you know about emerging technology? They say, here is my chatbot. You just see. Okay. No question asked, because you are demonstrating that you are not only knowing the function, you're not only knowing about the business, but you're also knowing about the technology. Nobody expects them to make chatbot, let me tell you, because that is something which the technical guys will do. You know, like in the lab, we made oxygen and whatever all gases. Am I making that every day? No, it was just for us to learn and find out that how this entire process works. Okay. So you in an IT company, I made my career in IT company. I started in Tata Group, where I was a functional guy. I was in a shop floor. I joined IBM. And then its career took me because I knew about the function of how a business works up. I had an MBA degree. And then IBM utilized me. I have done about 100 projects. Okay. I mean, I don't want to waste my time. What you'd have to do is just go to the Google, type my name, right? Sanjeeva Shankar Dubey. You will get 1 lakh entries, period. And that is kind of professor are going to teach you. Okay. And there are many. I mean, I'm just one of them. There are 70 others. Okay.
So suddenly a lot of questions have started pouring in.
They will.
there's one thought which is awaiting a response for.
Yeah, tell me.
Asimbe has written a comment. Probably you can share your thought on this. So he says, sound good and easy to work with digital technologies in the metropolitan cities, but how do we impact the rural remote areas to start up a digital business?
You can start a digital business. Let me share with you one example. Very example. I am example guy. Okay. I explain my theory. So 20 years ago, you know, forget about 5 years. I'm saying 20 years ago, around 18 years ago, there was an earthquake in Gujarat. Okay. Very, very serious earthquake. And I was contacted by the FICCI, the chairman of the FICCI, Mr. Loda. He said that, can we do something? Okay. The FICCI, as you know, is a industry body. So we said, yes, how the technology can help this earthquake? He said, look, we can help them to provide livelihood. He said, how? So the Gujarat Anjar region, you know, the Kutch Anjar region, there are villagers and especially ladies who make some, you know, the pillow covers and the tablecloths and then they add some mirrors and so on. Okay. So these people used to do it. Now you will find them in Janpath and then boutique shops where they will charge you exorbitant price of 1,000 rupees or so of 900. But really these ladies or these villagers get very little. Okay. Maybe say 100 rupees or so. So what we did was that we created an e-commerce site. And this site worked like this. The design, because everybody is not going to buy pillow covers. So what we did is we roped in the students of NIFT, National Institute of Fashion Technology. And we said, ask the professor, can these your students design it on the computer-aided design for those items which can be used in 5 stars and corporates and so on. So they found out that in corporate room, this could be used and that could be used. Now this design will be electronically sent to a coordinator, okay, a NGO coordinator called CARE. So what they will do is that they will explain the design to the group of villagers. They will give them the supply. And when the villager comes up, they will write their product code or something. And it will be directly sent. Where it will send? The website was created by FICCI, where the people can go and buy directly. So Hotel 5 Star and all the members of the FICCI, they started to use that site. And not only the pillow covers, there are a whole lot of artisan work they started to do. Where did it happen? Anjar region, Kutch. Only thing is that you have to be a little realistic that in the metropolitan, there are areas, even my home in the heart of Delhi, the signal does not come. Okay, so I have to go out. So don't worry about the technology in the region. If government is providing fiber optics to every village, okay? The future is better than today. So if you want to do some business, start today. We have got an entrepreneur cell. They will help you. Okay, don't worry about it. Technology is no excuse.
Sir, Anamay Pandey wants to know, sir, I have 1.8 years of experience as software engineer. So is this going to help me edge over others, and am I going to be provided with opportunity to apply my technical knowledge in BIMTech, like programming skills? Are they useful to any extent?
Okay, so my answer to do is that MBA is different than software programming. Okay, so what you have done is a great thing. You can continue use it. If this skill may be used, there may be some projects where a little bit of Python programming or something need to be done. So definitely you will have an edge, but it will depend upon what type of courses you choose in MBA. Now within MBA, we have got a lot of internship program where we allow students to develop their applications. We have got a digital commerce program where people generate their web app or website or do that, or the emerging technology program. So you can skill that. But I can also tell you for others. One of my student in, I think Anshuman will know, there was a Subham Agrawal, okay, with last year, he said, sir, how can I do? I'm a BCom. I said, no. For learning, there is no criteria that nobody can learn. Okay. So if you want to learn, you can learn it. And then he proved to be a far better learner than some people who came with IT background. So my answer is both. You will have the edge, but once you come to the new arena, there'll be others who are also going to compete with you. Okay. So you have to maintain that edge. Okay. You have to learn faster.
Sir, Akash Prasar wants to know, sir, I'm in final year of BTech as I'm doing graduation in computer science, cyber security, and currently planning to pursue MBA/PGDM. Sir, how an MBA or PGDM from BIMTech will help me out? Sir, I am more inclined towards managerial and leadership roles.
Okay, so, you have to choose your specialization accordingly. What you can choose your specialization is that depending upon, if you only want to choose the managerial role, then you have got a specialization in marketing and HR and so on. Then we have got a vertical specialization where we make you specialize in banking, financial, BFSI or digital analytics or IT and ITS. So it is your choice, you know. I mean, each one of them, there is a pie of the opportunity which you can aim it to. There is someone who is totally unhappy. He says it's very boring lecture. Do you all agree that it's a boring lecture? Someone who has... That's the problem of the cyber world, sir.
No problem. We have also shared the feedback link. Feel free to give us your feedback. No,
please. I'm okay. I mean, this lecture is boring, then I must change myself. So...
There is one more question from Lina, sir. Can you please tell us, is it good to do MBA in food technology and what are their scope?
I don't know. In the sense that we do not offer any specialization in food technology. Generally, you do not give MBA in technology. You know, food industry is an industry where food processing and everything can take place. Typically, those people who are hired in the business function, they are normal MBAs who go there. Okay. And so you can do a proper MBA and then you can join food processing industry, which are indulged in the making food items, you know. And there is a whole lot of scope, let me tell you. India has got a problem of we have got a surplus food production, but our farmers don't get the right price because when they produce, it is in excess. Okay, so they have to sell it at whatever rate to the. Now the government has giving some more freedom for them to sell, but they will be selling at a low price. Now we do not have place to store them. We cannot convert them into a processed item. So okay, if we allow them to do it, and then we can put some idea together, some businesses together. There is a whole lot of scope to be done. You know, we have to convert the raw food into a proper packaged food, okay? And that is where people like you can make the difference.
Sir, for your session, I have already started receiving feedback and people are saying that no, sir, it's very informative, it's very interesting, it's knowledge enhancer. Now I will move on to the next question, sir. Sasi wants to know, what are the IT related skills in the field of insurance? If you can throw some light on that question, sir.
Okay, so we have a few courses in IT insurance. One is called InsurTech. Okay, so what happens is there are, remember my two videos, you can watch them again. My two videos say very simply, IT has got two roles. One is that it will help us achieve the impossible using technology. And there is a commando video where the technology is a bamboo. Now the InsurTech. InsurTech is their backend functions of the insurance can be automated by using this, technology. You know, they are how to sell the policies, how to claim, make the claim process faster, and so on and so forth. And second is that the business model of insurance itself. Now, for example, if I have to give insurance to a vehicle, today by IoT devices and GPS connectivity and type of driving habit, I can have a different premium for different drivers, because I can say, look, this guy is not a good driver, so he will have more risk. If my healthcare, if my profile can be very maybe made available, of course this has got privacy issue, but I can definitely get a better premium. Insurance can get better premium. Lot of frauds can be detected by using the technology. So insurance has got a whole lot of application of insurance, InsurTech. Maybe you can go to our website, and if interested, just pencil in a mail to our admission team. They will tell you how InsurTech companies are, how the course is. And then in that course, we allow them to use blockchain for insurance. We allow them to use IoT for insurance. We allow them to do AI work in the insurance. So insurance industry is changing, actually. As a matter of fact, most industry are changing. Even education is changing. Just you think about it, all of you, 26 of you participants, how am I talking to you? As if I am just 2 feet away from you, 1 foot from my camera, another 1 foot from your camera. Okay. In the face-to-face class also, I would have never come so close. Okay. Because of the social distancing. The social distancing says 6, kitna, do gaj bolte hai na, Modi ji. So 6 feet. So,
sir, after technology advancement, I think social distancing or physical distancing has also become just a misnomer.
Yeah.
We are connected through technology than ever before.
In fact, just to add here, what Anshuman's point is, that when I was, in 2010, 29 to be precise, I was asked by IBM that we have got an job for you, or a role for you, because you are doing good job here. I was heading the IBM Airtel account, which was a 250 crores revenue of every year. So they said, do you have a job for you to head the Asia Pacific IT? So I thought I will be placed in Singapore or Japan or Tokyo or wherever in China. So I was very happy. But the next sentence my boss says, but you will be located at your home. You have to prove that how we can work remotely and supervise the work without using the technology like video call and conference call and the processes and so on. You can travel. There is no problem in traveling. You can travel 200 days a year, but better that you work remotely. So that art I practiced. And then when this remote class started in January, in the month of March end, it was very comfortable. I started helping my old colleagues. Okay. I said, I know this game. Okay. Please come to me. Okay. And then all our colleagues enjoyed that. As a matter of fact, the entire country has changed. Entire world has changed, and they have picked up this technology. Okay. Even the small children have picked up this technology.
No, let me take this opportunity to, in fact, thank you, sir, and inform the participants that with your vast experience, what we are experiencing right now, you have done it already a decade ago. To your experience, we were able to very smoothly transition to the online mode of teaching and learning. I'll take another question, sir.
Yes.
Sahil has just written opportunities after COVID-19. Probably he is a little apprehensive whether COVID-19 will lead to any sort of job cuts, job roles, because companies are cutting down their productivity margins, etc., etc. So it's a little apprehensive about the emerging job sector post COVID-19.
So Sahil, is a question from Sahil?
Yes, sir.
So Sahil, you will be maybe 20 years or 18 years, I don't know. Are you good with thinking that the world is going to remain the same way for next 100 years? No. It is going to change. Okay. Even today, the things have changed. The quarterly numbers have increased. Definitely, when nobody was buying anything, nobody was moving out. So obviously, the businesses were not doing the work. But that is almost gone beyond. You know, there are vaccines will come up. So in next three to six months time, by the time you graduate, I think the world will become normal. And it is not the first time. It has happened many times. Okay. Maybe you may not remember, you must be young. 2008, the same situation happened. 2001, the same situation happened when the terrorist strike took place in the world. Maybe that scale was a little different. So it's an economic cycle. It will go to the economic cycle. There may be some losses in certain sectors, but there are other sectors which are pulling it up. Just open up the economic times and then you will find that what the growth is taking place. So my question to you is that what will you do? Even if you are a friend, say, what will you do? So sit tight. Do nothing is not the option. Do nothing is not the option. Your option is to do something. Utilize this time to skill yourself. You know, utilize your time to increase your skill. You know, take up the course. This is the right time to take the course. But because that time you will complete, and I'm sure these people are aspirants, by the time you complete in 2022 or 2023, the world will be back to normal. Okay? So, The other thing I suggest to everybody is, can you change? Can you generate a vaccine? No, you can't do. So don't worry about it, because somebody else who is more capable than us is doing their job properly. Okay. Our job is to do my job properly. Okay. My job is to teach. Your job is to learn. Okay. So instead of sitting idle or doing some courses which are not going to make any sort of profile change, you should do something. So I like Kaushalendra. Okay, Kaushalendra, excellent talk. Thank you, Kaushalendra.
Sir, Yogita is asking a question. What all technical aspects are needed to be learned for an MBA? And which specialization should I take from BIMTech for getting into digital and tech business?
This question you should ask after you have spent 3 to 6 months time in BIMTech, because your faculty will guide you. And to me, it looks that you are very focused about your goal. Now, with somebody who is very focused about the goal, achieving that goal will become far more easy. You only need some mentoring and guidance and MBA course. Right now, we do not know your profile. So answering that, you know, you should take this or that will not be good, you know. As a professional manager, as a professional teacher, we will have, we have got a counseling session with every student. They help them select, but we do not allocate the specialization in the first day. We let them go through the normal program for, I think, three semesters is a common to all. And after that, the specialization papers start. So you will have sufficient time to choose yourself. But looks to me that you are a right candidate for IT and ITS specialization, because you are focused. You know what you want to do. Jinhe jo chahiye tha mil gaya unko adhik ya kam. Jinhe jo chahiye tha mil gaya unko adhik ya kam. Hame kya chahiye ye sochte hi reh gaye hum. So there are a lot of people who will keep thinking, ye karna hai, nahi karna, main yahan jaun, wahan jaun. Don't do that. You are focused, just achieve it.
Sir, Akash has typed this question twice. I don't know how relevant it is, but still, if you are able to provide some thoughts. He says, hello, sir, what passive income source are available for finance managers?
passive income, I can't understand. What is passive income? Side income.
His question is not very clear.
There are many ways to earn money. Okay, but you should earn money through a legal and logical means. Okay, you can earn money by trading in the stock market. For that, you need not come to MBA. Okay? I'm telling you very frankly, there are brokers and traders. They are the MBA. No, they are not. But if your idea is to, remember, if you generate a skill in yourself, if you become more skillful, then the money will come to you. You don't have to chase money. Money will come, your job will come to you. Opportunities will come to you. Okay. So at this stage, I will feel that do not worry too much about making money. Worry more about grooming yourself. Because the moment you groom yourself, there'll be a lot of avenues opened up. The same MBA program, if you become an investment banker, and then you might get good salaries, you'll also get great bonus. Okay. But if you're joining somewhere else, maybe you will get less money. But how do we distinguish between the two? Your skill, how you have performed or you have done during your courses or how you have performed during the interview and so on.
Sir, with this, we have now come towards the end of our session. I'll just take a last question from Akash Prasar. He's asking, sir, what technology is being used in retail industry? Does the engineering background help us to enhance while pursuing MBA? As I can see, BIMTech has very nice structured course as it is one of top B school offering PGDM in retail.
So there are nine technologies. I think I shared with you in retail industry, there are nine technologies. Maybe I skipped that chart very fast, but there are nine technologies. Okay. And in retail industry, they use all of them. As a matter of fact, the retail industry is forefront of using the technology. They are the first one to go become e-retail. Okay. They are the first one. Before education became e-education, they became retail 20, 15 years ago. Now there are robots used in the warehouses. There are big data being used to analyze that. There are AI, ML, almost all. Beacon is used in the retail industry to identify if a customer travels with you and then give them the suggestions for buying some new product in the malls or some other place. So in our retail course, we have got three specialization on the technology side: digital commerce, emerging technology, and then artificial intelligence. So if you have got this background of engineering, you are supposed to be a little bit more already equipped. Okay, already equipped. But remember, as I told, not to discourage others, even if you do not know, it doesn't matter, because if you have a desire to learn, you will run faster.
Okay, I'll now for the last time request all the participants to please provide your feedback. This will help us in constantly improving and bringing to you relevant and interesting topics for the webinar. Let me also inform you and take this opportunity to let you know that BIMTech also has a dedicated Facebook admissions group for the 202123 batch. So you can search it online. Please do join us for the latest updates, notifications, and for a Q&A session. Towards the end of this month, we'll organize a Facebook live session with the admission chair. So here is the Facebook group on your screens right now. Please do join this group. We'll be subsequently organizing similar webinars, similar Facebook live sessions. The next, we have planned an admission info session with chairperson admission towards the end of this month. So in order to attend that session, do join this group at the very earliest. With these words, I thank all the participants to sparing time for our webinar today. And thank you, Professor Dubey, once again for sharing your valuable thoughts on the topic and guiding the aspiring MBAs. Remember to pose in all your queries to admission or any other feedback you want to provide on the email ID admission@bimtech.ac.in. And thank you all till we meet again for the next webinar.
Okay, all the best. Thank you. Namaskar. Or all the young students, aap log bahut khush raho. Theek hai? Positive raho.
Thank you for the blessings, sir. I'll close the session now. Thank you all.